वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स इन द सीरीज ऑफ ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी वेयर डिस्कसिंग डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम रिलेटेड टू चैप्टर सिमिलर ट्रायंगल। नाउ इन दिस क्लास टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस वन इम्पॉर्टेंट थियोरम ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, that is the theorem related to areas of similar triangles. This theorem related to the areas of similar triangle. The statement of the theorem is, the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to the square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. Children, this is the statement of theorem which you should understand and keep memorize it, because this statement is used as a tools or as a formula in solving the sums related to area of similar triangles. So the theorem says that the ratio of the areas of two triangles is equal to the square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. This is the theorem which I discussed you in a short form. Suppose there are two triangles, triangle ABC and PQR, and it is being given that triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Now you need to show that the ratio of the area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to the ratio of the square of their corresponding sides. It means that you need to prove AB by PQ ka square is equal to AC by PQ square equals to BC by QR square. This is the statement of the theorem which you need to prove. Now let's see how this theorem can be proved. When we prove a theorem, any theorem, first we write given. So children, in this question it is given that triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. So thereafter, what is to prove? We write to prove. We need to prove area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to a square of their corresponding sides, ratio of the square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. So AB by PQ square equals to AC by PR square equals to BC by QR square. These two are the corresponding sides of both similar triangle. In this theorem, to prove it, we need a construction. And the construction is that we draw altitudes. We draw AM and PN, altitudes of triangle ABC and PQR on side BC and QR. Altitudes means AM is perpendicular on BC and PN is perpendicular on QR. So this is the required construction. We need to prove it. Construction is that draw altitudes AM and PN of triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Now let's see how it been proved. So proof. Since children, triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, these two triangles are already given similar, so their corresponding angles must be equal. So now we have by the property of similarity that angle A is equal to angle P, angle B is equal to angle Q, angle C is equal to angle R. Here you can see in the figure also, angle A corresponds to angle P, which are equal, angle B corresponds to angle Q, which are equal, and angle C corresponds to angle R, which must be equal. So when two triangles are similar, then their corresponding angles are equal and the corresponding sides are proportional also. So we have AB by PQ equals to AC by PR equals to BC by QR. These are the corresponding sides of the triangle. You can see in the figure also, AB is proportional to PQ, AC is proportional to PR, and BC is proportional to QR, and these corresponding sides must be proportional. Here we mention the region also, since in similar triangles, corresponding angles are equal and corresponding sides are in the same ratio. Now children, now we come in the triangle ABM and triangle PQN. We have angle B equals to angle Q, which is by the property of similarity of triangle ABC and PQR, and angle M equals to angle N, which is equal to 90 degree. So here we are making triangle ABM. In triangle ABM and triangle PQN, we have angle B equals to angle Q, which is given, angle M equals to angle N, which is 90 degree. Therefore, by the property of angle-angle property, triangle ABM becomes similar to triangle PQN by angle-angle property. And when these two triangles become similar, then their corresponding sides must be proportional. That is, AM by PN equals to AB by PQ equals to BM by QN, which are their corresponding sides. And suppose this is equation number third. When we prove triangle ABM similar to triangle PQN, then we have AB by PQ, AM by PN, and BM by QN, their corresponding sides. And suppose this is equation number third. Now, since AM and PN are altitudes of the triangle, AM and PN are altitudes. So, now we find the area of triangle ABC. Area of triangle ABC will become to equals to half into BC into AM by the formula half into base into height. And similarly, area of triangle PQR will becomes equals to half into QR into PN by the same formula half into base into height. Now divide the areas of these two triangles. So when we divide, then we have area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR. So the ratio of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equals to half into BC into AM by half into QR into PN. Half and half will get cancelled. So we have here BC by QR into AM by PN. And as you know that BC by QR is equal to AB by PQ. This is from equation number 2. Let's see the equation number 2. this is 2. Here we have BC by QR is equal to AB by PQ, because all three sides are proportional here. So BC by QR is equal to AB by PQ. So in this place, we can write BC by QR equals to AB by PQ. In substitute BC by QR by AB by PQ. And again, AM by PN is also equal to AB by PQ by equation 3. Let's see in the equation number 3. AM by PN is equals to AB by PQ. So here we are substituting the value of AM by PN by AB by PQ. AB by PQ. So now we got that area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equals to AB by PQ whole square. Suppose this is equation number 4. And from second, we can have that AB by PQ is equal to, see equation number 2, AB by PQ is equal to AC by PR equals to BC by QR. So now we can have, now from equation second, so now from equation second and 4, we can have the area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to AB by PQ whole square equals to AC by PR whole square equals to BC by QR whole square, because all three sides are proportional to each other. When you prove one side, then since all the remaining sides are proportional to each other, and in this way your theorem has been proved. Now students, let's see some questions based on the topic area related to similar triangle. Here are few questions based on the theorem which I have discussed now. So let's try to solve it. The question is, if triangle ABC similar to triangle QRP. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle QRP. And we have area of triangle ABC by area of triangle QRP equals to 9 by 4. It means that the ratio of the areas of two triangles, two similar triangles, are given 9:4. And we have the measurement AB equals to 18 centimeter and BC equals to 15 centimeter. Then we need to find PR. Then we need to find the length of PR. Let's see, here is the figure. Let's see, this is triangle ABC and this is triangle PQR. And here in this question, triangle ABC is similar to triangle QRP. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle QRP. It is given. And we have the measurement of length AB is 18 cm and length BC is of 15 cm. And now we have to find the length of PR. That is, this is to be find. So, since let's see the its solution, and solution is that it is given that triangle ABC is similar to triangle QRP. So when these two triangles are similar, then from the theorem which we have learnt now, that the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to the square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. So by that theorem, we have एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल एबीसी बाय एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल क्यूआरपी इक्वल्स टू बीसी बाय आरपी होल स्क्वायर बिकॉज ट्रायंगल एबीसी कोरेस्पोंडिंग साइड्स इज बीसी एंड ट्रायंगल क्यूआरपी कोरेस्पोंडिंग साइड्स इज पीआर साइड बीसी इज कोरेस्पोंडेंस टू साइड पीआर सो by that property area of triangle abc by area of triangle qrp is equal to bc by rp whole square since the ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to the ratio of स्क्वायर्स ऑफ देयर कोरिस्पोंडिंग साइड्स सो बाय दैट प्रॉपर्टी नाउ इट इज इन द क्वेश्चन गिवेन दैट एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल एबीसी बाय एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल क्यूआरपी इज इक्वल टू 9/4 सो वी आर सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग द वैल्यू So 9/4 is equal to and BC was given 15 centimeter. So substituting the value of BC also. So we have 15 by RP whole square. 9/4 is the given ratio of the area of two similar triangles. And 15 is the measurement of the side BC. So thereafter, on solving it, we have 9/4 can be written in this form 3/2 whole square. 3 square is 9, 2 square is 4. So 9/4 can be written in 3/2 whole square. And here on RHS side, 15 by RP whole square. Now on LHS side and RHS side, both sides are power 2. So this power 2 will get cancelled. So after being cancelled it, now we are left with 3/2 is equal to 15 by RP. Now after doing cross multiplication, we have RP equals to 15 into 2 by 3. 3, 5 is 15. So it will go by 5 times. And 5 into 2 equals to 10 centimeter. Hence, this 10 centimeter is the required length of the side PR, which is answer. Now, let's see another question. That is, in this question, in the given figure, if DE is parallel to BC, find the ratio of area of triangle ADE and area of DECB. Let's see the figure. Suppose this is the triangle ABC in which it is being given that DE parallel to BC. And the measurement of DE is 6 centimeter and measurement of BC is 12 centimeter. Now we need to prove that we need to find the ratio of the area of triangle ADE and ratio of trapezium DECB. This is to find. And in this figure, it is only given that DE parallel to BC and the measurement of DE is 6 centimeter and measurement of BC is 12 centimeter. So let's see. Since DE parallel to BC, so let's see this angle 1 is equal to angle 2 by the corresponding angle. And this angle 3 is equal to angle 4 due to corresponding angle. So, since DE is parallel to BC, therefore angle 1 equals to angle 2 and angle 3 equals to angle 4 by the property of corresponding angle. Therefore, this triangle ADE and triangle ABC are become similar because angle 1 is equal to angle 2 and angle 3 is equal to angle 4. So these two triangles become similar. Triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC by angle-angle property. And when these two triangles become similar, then area of triangle ADE by area of triangle ABC is equal to the square of the ratio of their corresponding sides, that is DE by BC whole square. And the measurement of DE was given 6 and BC was 12. So 6 by 12. And 6, from 6, 12 will go 2 times. So now we have 1 by 2 whole square, that is equals to 1 by 4. Hence, from here it is clear that the ratio of triangle ADE and triangle ABC is equal to 1 is to 4. Now, let us assume, let area of triangle ADE equals to 1K and area of triangle ABC equals to 4K. Now, from as you can see from the figure, when you subtract triangle ADE, area of triangle ADE from area of triangle ABC, we will have DECB, area of trapezium DECB. So, for area DECB, we have area of triangle ABC minus area of triangle ADE, which is equal to 4K minus 1K, that is equal to 3K. Because area of triangle ABC was 4K and area of triangle ADE was 1K. And after subtraction, we have 3K. Now, we need to find the area of triangle ADE by area of DECB. So, we now got the area of ADE is 1K and area of DECB is 3K. So, 1K by 3K, KK will get cancelled. So, now we have 1 by 3. Hence, the required ratio of area of triangle ADE is to area of trapezium DECB is equal to 1 is to 3, and this is your required result. Now, students, I hope that all of you understand in well and try to solve some more questions based on the area of similar triangles to get more command on this topic. So keep trying and keep practicing.